sejahtera untuk semua yang hadir hari ini. Alhamdulillah, read the book, start the talk, dah bermula kepada siri yang ketiga. Betul? Kan? Okay, sebelum kita memulakan sesi resensi, keempat, maaf. Terima kasih Dr. Mahfuzah. Dah tersasul sekejap. So kita mulakan dengan Ummul Kitab Al-Fatihah dulu. Bismillah. Alhamdulillah. Kepada yang hadir hari ini, sesi kita hari ini akan bermula dengan perkongsian buku The Last Lecture oleh Puan Azmi Linda Zainuddin, pensyarah kanan Fakulti Kejuruteraan Elektrik. Mengenali beliau personally, kalau tengok daripada perawakan kita tak nampaklah dia suka buku tu. Kan, tapi sebenarnya dia pun senyum sipu je kan, sebab kita nak buat santai dan setiap orang ada trigger dia yang menyebabkan dia akan suka membaca. Dan saya pasti boleh tak Puan Azmi, kita sebelum mula sesi sharing buku tu, apa yang menyebabkan mula minat membaca tu? Sebab biasanya bila kita kata bidang kejuruteraan ni, orang tak suka baca. So stigma ni seperti itu. So kalau boleh share dengan kami.
Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Rabbi syrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa lahlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli ya arhamar rahimin. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, assalamualaikum semua. Terima kasih kepada Dr. Profesor Profesor Maja yang hadir untuk sesi petang ni. Terima kasih juga kepada Puan Tahira dan Dr. Mahfuzah yang yang approach saya untuk perkongsian ni. Di mana saya pun betul lah, jarang jugalah nak apa ni kongsi macam ni, saya segan. Okay, so so you said the stigma engineering, apa ni, people don't read books. Saya tak tahu lah, saya pun tak nak generalizekan lah, but talking about myself, saya baca buku yang praktikal. Buku yang teknik, apa yang praktikal lah, praktikal. So so betul, macam dulu masa kecil-kecil sebenarnya bukan background yang sebenarnya diterapkan dengan membaca lah, okay. Tapi bila dah besar tu, di surrounded by friends, lepas tu dan sebenarnya buku ni saya jumpa, jadi this is the book saya dapat masa saya started my work dekat Pasir Gudang lah. So a friend, masa tu actually pergi apa pesta buku popular RM5. So come across this book RM5, macam juga Puan Tahira kan, jumpa, beli buku dekat apa tu. Okay, so it's a famous book. Badan telah sahabat tu cakap it's a famous book. So bila first time buka tu memang nampak like it's a practical book. Buku yang macam straightforward sebenarnya start ni, and it actually is a self, I would say that it's a self-help book. It's a sebenarnya buku about motivation and how you handle your life. So does that answer the question so far?
Okay lah, sebab you dah jelas nyata dan terang kata you baca buku yang practical, so somehow it triggers you to share. Betul tak? Kalau tidak takkan suka-suka nak share kan? So tak apa. Betul. Tujuan kita buat, orang kata tujuan kita buat lisensi buku ni pun sebab kita nak, Waalaikumsalam Samsul. Terima kasih pada yang baru join. Kita buat lisensi buku ni pun bukan setakat buat sinopsis. Itu yang kita nak fahamkan kepada semua orang yang ada di sini, dan mungkin semua orang pun dah tengok banyak program ulasan buku yang ada. Tapi yang kita nak buat sekarang ni ialah kita nak buat satu kelainan daripada buku yang kita baca. Apa yang menyebabkan ada orang kata trigger kehidupan kita, apa yang menyebabkan boleh kita ke hadapan lagi. So kalau kita tengok sesi-sesi sebelum ni, kalau saya boleh garapkan sedikit, sesi satu saya share macam mana buku tu, macam mana nak save your own life. Nombor dua, asuhan budi. Okay, macam mana kita nak didik adab tu sendiri. Nombor tiga, buku. Nombor tiga ni bagi saya memang orang kata sedikit terkejut sebab saya tak pernah baca pun. Tengok pun tajuk dia, alamak, sukarnya nak baca. Tapi bila tengok intipati, saya pun terdiam nak berurusan dengan individu sukar. So hari ni, frankly speaking, Last Lecture was my favourite book. Tapi saya suka dengar daripada perspektif yang lain. Okay, So without further ado, tanpa melengahkan masa, saya serahkan kata sesi ini kepada Puan Azli Linda untuk berkongsi dengan kita semua pada hari ini mengenai buku yang beliau baca. Dipersilakan.
Okay, terima kasih Puan Tahira. Okay, saya kongsikan dulu slide saya. Okay, so tajuk dia The Last Lecture by Randy Posh. Okay, tadi saya cerita dekat Tahira, this book yang first saya beli tu, saya, itulah when I sit down with my friends and then when we talk about books, I talk about this book lah. And then I decided to kasih the first copy yang saya beli tu dekat kawan, tapi saya pun tak ingat siapa yang dapat buku tu. And then the next sale ada kat Big Bad Wolf, masa tertentu like RM8 kot, then I bought two copies of it. Okay, so ini kat sini ada banyak version lah, even ada satu copy being translated in Bahasa Melayu. So this is a lot of version of this book. So memang apa itulah, it's a popular book which I also, yes, apa recommend everyone to have a look at it. Okay, so it's by Randy Posh, nama dia Randolph Frederick Posh. Okay, so he is, okay, he is actually a lecturer, a computer engineering lecturer dekat Carnegie Mellon University, Pittsburgh, okay, US. And this is actually a private research university. So they have this session where they call it the last lecture. So the last lecture ni is where they invite like all the prominent, the top professors untuk kasih apa talk as if it is their last day to give a talk. So like they should be like sharing what are the things that they want to pass to the students before they end their life. And it so happened that sebenarnya Randy Posh ni pun sebenarnya semasa dia di invite, sebenarnya dia di queue lah, tapi masa dia di invite tu, beberapa bulan sebelum tu dia baru tahu yang dia ada pancreas cancer. So dia tak sure sama ada dia boleh bagi talk tu ke tak kan, which is scheduled in September, masa tu like a few months forward. Tapi he decided to say yes. And then macam mana tak to the apa ni, since that dia macam push too much untuk focus on this like on presenting the lecture lah, the lecture. Sampaikan wife dia pun cakap lah, why are you putting so much time on ni lah giving, preparing for this. Tapi telah dia kata tak tahulah, okay, to him like this is something he need to look into lah. Okay. So okay, this is the summary lah that I explained just now. Okay, dia punya lecture, he give a title which is the title of his lecture was Really Achieving Your Childhood Dreams. Okay, this was presented in 2007. Okay, and then then he converted his speech into this book. Okay, with Jeffrey Zaslow, kalau tak silap, this one from journal from Wall Street. Okay, and then so dalam buku ni dia share actually more than 25 life lessons lah, but then what I will share with you sikit je lah, tak apa, mungkin 5 sahaja, but then kita go detail a bit on each of it. Okay, tapi if you read it, memang tak tahu, I tak tahu macam banyak buku sometimes it takes some time for me to complete it, tapi this one I will say like one day dah habis lah. So ada juga buku-buku lain lah yang memang kena sesuai dengan diri saya, which I managed to read it in one day. Tapi tak banyak. Okay, so one of the lesson is about brick wall. So dalam brick wall ni, dia cerita, the chapter dalam brick wall ni, soalnya dia cerita macam mana he met his wife. Masa tadi dia dah around 36 macam tu. And then he was presenting a talk dekat the university. Pasal kebetulan his wife was the student who was handling apa dia jadi orang tengah lah, jadi apa orang tengah untuk handle the talk session. So so that was the time lah that he met. Tapi it's like banyak sangat challenges that memang dia decided lah to apa untuk berkahwin dengan wife dia, tapi banyak sangat challenges that macam sebab dia tempat yang berbeza tau. Masa dia dah bagi talk tu, it was at a different part of the US. So it's like difficult for his wife, which is nama dia Jay, spells J-A-I, but he said to pronounce it Jay. It was the challenge macam susah untuk diorang to be together, tapi dia tu lah, he have this apa ni yang dia berpegang teguh lah kepada satu kata-kata, dia kata that's the challenge kan, which is this challenge is a brick wall. So this brick wall yang kita hadapi, the challenge yang kita hadapi are there for a reason. They are not there to keep us out, but the brick walls are there to give us a chance to show how badly we want something. And sebenarnya this brick wall sebenarnya yang membezakan kita yang dah pass through dengan orang yang tidak. So orang this wall sebenarnya adalah that separate lah, the people who wanted it badly enough and the one yang tidak mahu sebenarnya mencapai that impian. So dia cerita about he himself and his wife kan. But then from there kita sebenarnya boleh nampak lah sebenarnya bila kita nak go through any of our plan, any of our dreams kan, ada banyak challenges. Sometimes kita mental block, kita tak tahu. Tapi sebenarnya itulah sebenarnya yang membezakan kita yang memang nak achieving our dream dengan orang yang sebenarnya tak kisah pun achieving ataupun tak, so dia terstuck dekat brick wall tu. So from there, itulah is you have to always remember that itulah never give up, okay, in your dream. So his title was Living Your Childhood Dream kan. So dalam tu ada beberapa lainlah childhood dream that he also explained how macam mana dia manage to achieve it. Okay, so the next one. Okay, this one quite interesting lah. So masa dia kecil-kecil kan, masa dia kecil around 8 years old, he visited Disneyland, so which is in 1969. So Disneyland dekat California. The one in California. So masa dia pergi tu memang he was wow dengan apa yang ada dekat Disneyland tu. So dia memang cakap lah, okay, one day I really want to be part of this, I want to do this. Macam dia bukan nak datang lagi tempat tu, tapi dia nak buat benda tu. So that was one of his childhood dream. And then dalam lama dia pun proceed with his studies. Semua sampailah dia completed his PhD. Okay, dia completed his PhD is in computer engineering. Okay, so dia pun back to his he remember he really wanted to work with Walt Disney. Okay, so dia ada satu ni lah, dia Walt Disney Imagineering. So dia apply for the post Walt Disney Engineering. Okay, agak-agak dia dapat tak? Tahira, you rasa dia dapat tak? Unmute Tahira.
Sorry, soalan dia dapat ke tidak?
You rasa dia punya, itulah dia punya application to enter Walt Disney because he was graduated dengan PhD with computer engineering. Rasa dia dapat tak the post dekat Walt Disney? Macam tu memang ada vacancy lah.
Tak ingat jalan cerita dia lama.
Apalah, baca. You rasa. Tak apa, it's okay. You rasa dia dapat tak?
Tak good.
Okay, you rasa dia tak dapat. Okay. Tapi itulah, this one dia punya background, dia punya CV was very good. Tapi itulah, the result was that disappointing, dia tak dapat. So he was, memang dia...
Oh, baik.
Ini bukan soalan quiz. Okay, so but he was disappointed lah. Of course, macam dia nak sangat kan. You guys pun pernah rasa, you guys wanted something tapi tak dapat. Tapi tapi kan itulah, so dia still ingat dia punya brick wall punya mantra. Okay, okay, so this is the brick wall kan. So pada ketika itu macam yes you can rasa down, tapi jangan down terlalu lama lah. So down dan terus move on and think of something how to pass through that brick wall. So tapi since dia memang suka on masa tentu dia suka on virtual reality. Okay, virtual reality tahu kan yang that is it, this one was like 1995 tau. Sekarang ni kita baru being exposed dengan virtual reality, tapi sebenarnya 1995 lagi dia dah start lah the research ni lah on virtual reality. Okay, virtual reality tu macam ialah you yang kalau kita tengok banyak yang scan kat phone dia keluar gambar, ataupun kita boleh tengok dekat view the virtual apa environment kan, tapi semuanya virtual kan, macam dalam gaming. Okay, so so masa time tu dia attached to University of Virginia. So kat University of Virginia ni ada this event that calls this virtual reality on $5 a day. So masa time tu macam all the people yang work on this virtual reality research work, dia nak kumpul dana lah sebenarnya. So dia pun decided to make a team untuk work on this lah, untuk take fund macam tu. So masa ni dalam buku tu dia cakap dia teringat lah macam apa people dalam Hewlett Packard kan. Dan kalau kita jobs pun kan, diorang ada garage, they all buat all this project kan. So dia pun buat macam tu lah. Lepas tu kebetulan tiba-tiba dia dapat tahu the Walt Disney ni pun the Walt Disney Imagineering pun tengah venture into virtual reality. Tahu dia nak buat this virtual reality thing dalam Walt Disney. So dia pun excited lah sebab it relates to him kan. So dia pun terus call. Dia tanya, dia cakap macam ni, dia cakap I am currently a researcher working on this virtual reality work. So I would like to to collaborate and to understand more on how Walt Disney. Tapi sebenarnya intention dia nak masuk lah kan dalam tu, dia nak kerja kat situ. So masa time tu, so macam ni daripada the first phone call yang dia buat tu, he managed to, dah cari call dia orang ni pas, dia, tapi he managed to talk to John Snoddy. Okay, John Snoddy ni masa time tu memang terkenal dengan orang yang, very good in this. Okay, sekejap ada dengan bunyi bising kat belakang eh. Sekejap. Okay, sekejap ni okay ke? Okay. Boleh okay, Zainal? Okay.
Boleh. It's just that we are having fun ada suara kat belakang tu.
Okay. So, kita fokus on this, okay? Then he managed to talk to John Snoddy. Okay, tapi dia dekat Virginia, right? But then John Snoddy was in California. Tapi, dalam call tu dia terus nak cakap. The next call he called, dia kata dia ada plan, dia akan pergi ke California for some discussion. So he was thinking of meeting John Snoddy. Tapi sebenarnya tak pun, dia just reka cerita tu. So bila kalau John Snoddy say yes, then memang dia decided to book his flight and terus pergi lah. So then kebetulan betul, John Snoddy kata okay boleh meet up. So dia pun meet up and sebelum meet up tu, dia prepare very well lah, they study about this person itself, they study about Walt Disney, and they study about the project that Disney wanted to do. So masa dia present tu, so John was macam very wow lah on his presentation. So dekat sini kita tahu lah kan, when we want to present something, kan, to achieving what we want, so you have to actually prepare well and do study all that, okay. So masa time tu Disney cakap dia tak tahulah macam mana nak do this collaboration kan. Lepas tu terus Randy Paul cakap dia tengah on sabbatical, dia boleh apply for sabbatical. Itu pun sebenarnya dia create benda tu. Lepas tu then Disney cakap okay boleh, Then so dia sekarang tengah dah ni lah dah tersangkut nak kena discuss dengan dia punya head of department on how he can do the sabbatical. Because there is an issue about IP tu semualah. Lepas tu, tapi itulah to cut it short. In the end, itulah the apa the boss his superior okay approve and he managed to get the apa to get and to enter the Walt Disney Imagineering. Okay, tapi itulah bila kalau baca cara dia ceritakan after dia dapat je yes of entering to he was like so happy and then dia go back home and itulah menangis dalam kereta. You know, it's like that all yang he always wanted dapat kan. So after he passes the big wall. Okay, so that's on. Okay, and this
nak tanya sikit Puan Zina.
Okay,
just
boleh.
Nak interframe. Bila tadi dah cerita sebab first year kita dah tahu yang dia tak dapat at first. Kan? So dalam ni yang brick wall mantra yang dia apply ialah selepas dia being denied, betul? And
first one,
still dia dan dia overwhelm juga masih lagi dengan nak kata macam mana ya, stubbornness ke ataupun how I would like to say this, kalau you baca tu how do you portray the part yang dia cuba lagi dan cuba lagi tu, sebab kalau saya dah being denied tu dah tak ada dah.
Oh, saya apa okay, the way I look at it kan, dia nampak the chances tu sebenarnya banyak peluang that he can actually create to give him a to him, give him a, to give himself a chance to enter that. So So macam ni lah. Memang if you want to achieve kan anything kan sebenarnya, you need to have all of this information baru you can cari laluan yang betul. Then you have to try, kan?
Kalau maknanya tak ada satu pilihan, dia tak dia nak, maknanya dekat sini dia nak masuk Walt Disney tu. Kan?
Itu dia punya goal. Yes.
Itu dia punya goal. So walaupun daripada Virginia ke California dengan duration macam tu, still dia push diri dia, dia pastikan yang dia aim tu dapat, betul kan?
Yes, betul. So from there also we can see kan, if you have a clear goal kan, you don't really care about the brick wall, right? You will actually try to pass that brick wall. So this one kalau search dekat ni, Google Scholar ni adalah ni one of the paper lah. This one is the Aladdin that he works on for the Disney. Okay, on that time. Okay, so okay, next is the next lesson is on people. People are more important than things. So masa ni dia baru beli dia punya kereta ni lah. Apa, kereta dia Volkswagen Cabrio. So dalam buku dia tak ada kot gambar, so this one I just Google. Okay, Volkswagen Cabrio. Okay, so dekat sini, this one saya just letak apa ni, just actually to assist me to present. Okay, so dekat sini, dia baru beli kereta dia. Okay, so dia ada anak buah. Okay, masa tadi dia tak kahwin lagi, dia ada anak buah dua orang. Okay, dan dia memang rapat lah. Biasanya weekend atau twice a month dia akan bawa anak buah dia keluar. So ni masa dia baru first time beli kereta ni. So masa first time dia baru beli kereta ni, dia bawa lah anak buah dia keluar. Dia kata jom. Okay, tapi kakak dia cakap, kakak dia dah warn lah anak dia ni. Okay, jangan kotor-kotorkan ni kereta baru Uncle Porsche. Okay, be careful kan. Tapi masa time tu macam Porsche tak berapa selesa lah with that kind of advice kan. So dia dia ambil air soda, air tin lah. Lepas tu dia terus buka and then dia tuang dekat kerusi. Dekat kerusi baru kereta dia ni lah. Lepas tu dia cakap, this is just a car. Okay, this is just a car. It's okay to do dirty on it. It's okay. Because this is just a car. So you will learn a lot of things from this. So daripada sini kan, bila saya baca kan, macam sebenarnya macam saya tak ingat lah masa tu saya baca umur berapa kan. Masa tu mungkin baru ada anak kot. Saya rasa lepas tu, yelah, sometimes kita kan, kita macam tu kan, kita kadang marah anak kita tu sebabkan marah kan. Sebagai barang yang kita value so much. Tapi kita tak tahu sebenarnya betul when they do that benda, apa benda-benda yang macam tu sebenarnya actually they are learning something sebenarnya kan. So dia first start, dia kata we should value ni lah people more than this. So dia pun so dia selalu spend masa dengan anak dia. So talking about the pancake, itulah dia cakap okay, apa kalau anak buah dia dua orang ni keluar dengan dia kata rules first rules, let's do anything that we want to do. Masa tentu anak dia macam umur 7-6 tahun lah. 7-8 tahun anak buah dia. Lepas tu dia kata the next rule is jangan beritahu mak lah apa yang kita buat. Okay, tapi itulah dia orang buat benda-benda yang fun lah. So sometimes they do, dia pernah cerita buat lah. Dia cerita kan dia dalam buku tu dia cerita dia masak pancake. So dia tanyalah. Tak, anak buah dia tanya, kenapa pancake kena round? Kan, lepas tu dia cakap, ah betul, yeah, yes, true, yeah, why do should pancake be round, kan, kita boleh buat square, boleh buat ni, so you know, we don't limit our kids, macam ni lah, so when we don't limit, they tend to have a lot of chances of become creative, okay, so itulah, so this is a reality lah that happening right now ni, my kids tengah lomba-lomba kan, dah cakap kat diorang tadi. Daripada pagi tadi dah cakap dah, okay please 1 hour saja kan, I would like you to please jangan but then itulah
it won't happen sebab kita let them to be. Bagi saya lah konsep saya, we can do that, the boundaries, tapi kalau dia nak having fun, let it be what you can do in this kind of kata reality pandemic sekarang ni. Ini my opinion lah kan, but I think setakat ni pendengar semua dengar dengan jelas, nyata dan terang, so don't worry, you just continue je.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, tapi itulah memang apa, ada je benda yang kita boleh control sebenarnya kan. Apa, tapi itulah bila kita tengok kat ni, masa tu anak buah dia like 7 and 8. Sebenarnya 7 and 8 tau. Which is kita rasa, sometimes kita rasa, anak dari satu betul dah faham kan. Sebenarnya, no kan, if you read parenting book, kan parenting book is also a practical book, right? Itulah, yeah, we can learn a lot of things lah from there. Kan, even they also say that sebenarnya we are learning from the kids, right? Okay, so this is one of the value points like that I was triggered by ni lah, Randy Bosch. Okay, and okay, the next one is on time is finite. Ini pun kita tahulah dalam Quran kita kan ada ni surah, okay, apa tentang masa kan. Okay, so dekat sini Randy Bosch kata manage and use it wisely because it's finite. Apa finite or finite? How do you pronounce that, Tahira? Okay.
So, infinite lah. Supposedly lah kan. Kita anggap je lah macam tu.
So time is explicitly managed just like money. Okay. So okay, so ini ada 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 7 point lah about time. Okay, so don't invest your time on irrelevant details. Okay, so ini sebenarnya all of this sebenarnya dia actually apa share dengan students dia lah. Okay, so itulah sometimes bila kita tahu kan kita overthinking too much, right? So we shouldn't spend too much time on that. And then you can change your plan only if you have one. So in order to manage your time, you have to have plan lah. So dia ni dia kata he's a to-do list guy. Yang memang ada to-do list. Then I think a lot of people pun kan, a lot of you guys here yang kat sini yang memang jenis yang apa efficient people kan. Okay, you guys mesti ada to-do list, right? So bila, okay kat sini saya terus ni WFH report. So work from home report. So like yesterday we have to submit the work from home report, right? Siapa yang take time to fill up that report, sebenarnya we can say that like you don't really manage your time. Maybe you don't really manage your time properly. Because siapa yang macam value time kan, dia rasa macam oh every second is important, that you have to jot it down like what I want to do this next 15 minutes, what I want to do this next half an hour, when should I spend time with my kids, who should I spend time with, which of my kids should I spend time in this week, macam tu lah. So and also they also say like the more busy you are, the more organized you will be. So saya percayalah juga dekat tu, sebab sampai bila kita dah tiba-tiba free, kita dah lost kan macam macam saya dulu pernah saya pernah lah tak kerja, maksudnya after I apa kerja I sama master. Lepas tu tunggu posting ada like 8 bulan kot. So 8 bulan tu sebenarnya ada chance lah untuk being a full time wife. So tapi masa first week tu macam lost tau what to do. So then alhamdulillah I did Google lah what to do kan. What to do for a full time housewife. I did Google for that lah sebenarnya, to learn something lah. Okay, so dapatlah dia cakap you have to have a timetable. So alhamdulillah, so when you have timetable, you have me, so inilah, you can manage your time even though you are inilah, so you know, from transition kan, bila tak ada kerja. So the same thing lah. So even sekarang pun saya pun fikir macam nanti kalau pencin, nanti bila nak pencin tu nak kena buat apa, so kena plan, kena have that idea from now lah. Like, at least tak adalah plan jot down pun, it's okay kan, tapi at least you have, you dah pernah fikirkan about that, you have the dream, you have apa panggil vision board kan, so macam tu lah. Okay, itulah saya rasa all of you guys here yang itulah, especially yang dah lama bekerja, itulah understand lah about that, right? Kemudian so that's why kat sini dia kata you need to have a plan. And then next is ask, are you spending time on the right thing? So masa ni Randy Posh cerita that dia selalu collect ni apa artikel, apa nama syarikat khabar Virginia something lah, dekat masa time tu dia suka kumpul artikel. Dan one of the artikel ni ada gambar apparently woman holding a cigarette, tapi tengah pasal ni lah protest against a local construction site. So construction site tu buat apa drilling semua, so dia complain lah yang tu could harm her baby kan. Tapi at the same time like she was like holding dia tengah isap rokok kan, right? So it's like, are you spending time, should you be spending time on complaining that, or you should be spending time on just apa stop quitting your smoking kan. Which one is better? You need to, for you to solve the issue. So macam tu lah. So how can you do this? Is actually you always to revisit your to-do list and your short-term and long-term plan, so you can actually identify, you know, your time is spending on the right thing or not. And okay, so yang ni tak tahulah, yang ni kan dia ni ada filing system kat rumah. Saya tak pernah ada lah. Tadi dah pernah ada ke filing system kat rumah?
Ada, saya ada.
Tadi dah filing system apa? Boleh share tak?
Boleh, tak ada masalah. Okay, sebab bila kita menguruskan rumah, kerja, so filing system, dan kebetulan pula saya menguruskan husbandnya business, so semua kena ada. So LHDN ada satu personal, satu husband, satu business. So and then anak-anak pun ada filenya, sijil anak-anak pun ada filenya. Memang akan lengkap lah kalau rasanya. Bil-bil pun, utilities pun ada filenya. Saya akan simpan sampai 7 tahun recording system.
So you ada a rack or a shelf?
Yes, ada shelf untuk filing. Nanti wow. Bukti saya simpan, saya tunjuk eh. Wow. It's good sebenarnya, it's good, it's really good.
Okay, you should have one session on sharing for that. Okay.
So, nanti.
So dekat sini, dia cakap macam tu lah. Dia kata, okay, dia dengan wife dia suka filing tu dalam bentuk color. Tapi dia kata dalam bentuk, kan kita belajar 5S kan? So betul
nama 5S. Ini dia
colornya. Ha?
Ini dia colornya kalau nampak ni.
Nampak. Okay, warna biru. Ini nampak.
This is urgent one.
Okay. Okay. So itulah sebenarnya bila kita belajar 5S kan, sebenarnya kita boleh apply dekat rumah. Saya memang itulah, saya setujulah dengan benda tu. Okay. Tapi itulah bila saya tengok, bila kita LHDN lah yang paling penting, yang kita kena ada filing system. So sekarang kita boleh apply lah dalam cloud system kan, all the soft copies. So ini sebenarnya itulah Puan Suhana daripada FPDP lah baru advice saya untuk buat this thing lah. Okay. So any receipt semua kumpulkan ikut kategori. Okay, and then next is rethink the telephone. So masa time ni smartphone wasn't that smart. So dia selalu dapat phone calls lah. So dia kata about multitasking, when you have phone calls, you do multitasking, okay. Tapi what we can apply here, okay. Tapi salah satu poin yang dia kata, kalau kita nak short phone call, kita call orang. Tapi benda penting, tapi nak sekejap je kita tak nak ni, kita call pukul 11.55. Waktu tu like pukul 12 dah lunch kan. So you call at that time. So you're going to
saya have... nak share Azlin, saya nak share. Dia punya style yang inilah yang saya ambil sebab saya tak suka tulis message. So sebab dalam buku The Last Lecture ni, dia sebab dia kata jangan tak ambil phone calls, betul. Tapi make the phone calls too short. So dia bagi tips macam tu sebab saya ni jenis yang suka bercakap. So latih diri untuk buat short phone calls instead of orang kata you spend time bercakap lama-lama.
Betul. Betul. Masa tu pun dia cakap juga lah, bila lama phone call dia tak suka lah kan, having the apa ni, the phone on his ear so long. And then like the next what I can, how I can relate with our time right now kan, macam kita kena declutter lah all the activities dekat phone kita lah, sama ada macam social media, apa, maybe like taking too much time of us. So we should stop with that. Lepas tu and sometimes, okay, webinar pun sekarang ni like webinar banyak kan, at the same time ada banyak sangat webinar, tapi semua macam best punya webinar kan, macam sekarang ni pun banyak sangat at the same time. So how do you really manage that kan? So you have to plan lah. Okay, so sekarang ni kan bila kita tengok yalah, during the pandemic COVID, memang senang nak access to a lot of knowledge videos, tapi itulah macam mana you nak have an effective one. Okay, the next thing he say about delegating the time. So delegate ni itulah the task lah, macam kita pun biasa kan, delegate task kat student, dekat apa postgraduate students untuk kita punya project. Tapi kat sini dia tunjuk gambar ni lah, dia kata dia kena buat kerja tapi anak dia nak duduk dengan dia. So instead of pegang botol ni, dia delegate the bottle to anak dia. So okay, this is one of the simple example lah, okay, that you can do, and you can also teach your kids sebenarnya from this example. Okay, and then dia kata take a time out. So kalau pergi vacation, pergi ni, kalau keluar, kalau betul-betul memang tengah nak relax, off semua connection. So have it ni, and then work effectively. Just kalau, even though kalau work effectively, saya sekarang baru start guna ni lah, apa, Pomodoro. Okay, so bila time Pomodoro at 25 minutes, I switch off all of the ni lah, all of the notification of the, all of the phone, internet, and I can focus on my work. So itulah, work hard, okay, and play hard, right? Okay, and then this one, jangan satu, dua, okay, let's skip, okay. So this one, less complain, less stress. Saya suka ni sebab saya tak tahu lah, macam this few months tiba-tiba je saya rasa macam diri saya tiba-tiba banyak sangat benda nak complain tau. Then bila, betul, sebenarnya you complain, you tend to become stress. Sebab, and then I came across a research article, dia kata sebenarnya dia akan keluarkan satu actually hormone sebenarnya yang akan buat kita stress, and then dia akan like repeat cycle tu. So dekat sini dia kata his favorite non-complainer is Jackie Robinson. So this Jackie Robinson is African American who play Major League Baseball. Okay, so his number is 42. Okay, actually saya rasa ada movie dia, pasal saya tak tengok lagi, ada movie pasal dia. So dia first African American kan, tapi itulah, sepanjang dia main memang selalu kena bu, kena hitam, memang this racist issue lah, tapi dia tak pernah complain, dia tak pernah, but then he play his best sampai kan after dia dapat compete New York Yankees, okay, for baseball, Dodgers is Brooklyn, okay, dia dapat lawan New York Yankees. Lepas tu after his success, after dia dah stop retire playing baseball, dia bukan stop saja, dia fight for civil rights, and also dia buka bank, okay, dia buka business lah, which is a bank. So and why he managed to do that, because you know, less complain, and then when we have less complain, we it opens to a lot of doors for opportunities. So Randy Posh kata, convert your time and energy daripada complaining kepada solving the problems. So instead of complaining, and then you don't complain unless you can contribute. If you contribute, then you can complain, right? So itulah, saya pun tengok memang betul lah, kita patut instead of complain kita bersyukur. Sebab itulah, if you can control, then don't control. If you can control, senang, don't complain. Okay, but then bersyukur, and then the rest let Allah handle. Okay, situ ada typo error sikit. Okay, and then show gratitude. Okay, and the next one, this is the last one, lesson that I wanted to share. So this is, maybe one of my favorite juga. Okay, dia kata about the penguin story. Okay, saya kan suka penguin tak?
Suka, cerita Happy Feet.
Okay, so penguin ni ada kat mana? Dia belah southern, guys, belah ni lah. Belah Southern Hemisphere, okay. So, dia kata kat sini, building virtual world course, okay. So, masa time tu dia kena ajar satu course ni, dalam ni lah dia punya subject, tajuk dia building virtual world. Okay, masa time ni, it's a teamwork lah. So dia cakap kat budak-budak ni, kat student dia, okay, throw any ideas you want. No limit, no ni, jangan limit, jangan ni. Okay, lepas tu, explain lah what ada ni. Lepas tu, go through it sampai habis semester kan. So dia kata dia nak kasih satu award lah. Award dia, dia kata the best failure award nama dia. Okay, the best failure award. So ini adalah untuk team yang sanggup to take the biggest risk. So maksudnya depends on dia punya project, the progress sepanjang semester tu, apa, the team who apa who took the biggest risk akan dapat award ni. Tapi dia tukar nama tu kepada the first penguin award sebab itulah best failure is like a negative connotation kan, so it's definitely not good. So so dia cakap kat student, inilah always inilah, you know, because this one is like memang kena ada a new ideation have to come from the students, okay, for inilah for this project, okay. So so kenapa penguin ni? Okay, okay, before I go to the penguin, okay, dia cakap kat sini kan failure is, kita kata failure is accepted, right? Tapi sebenarnya failure tu sebenarnya is actually essential. You need that failure to become, yeah, someone better, okay? So why does this penguin? Tidak pernah ni tak? Tahu tak pasal penguin ni? Dia punya karakter dia.
Penguin dalam kumpulan.
Ha, betul. Penguin dalam kumpulan, yes. Betul. Okay, so penguin ni dia dalam kumpulan. Okay, tapi dalam kumpulan ni dia ada satu, okay, macam ni lah. Dia ni penguin ni dia sebenarnya okay, resilient, lepas tu apa? Bukan resilient, resilient. Okay, lepas tu dia they build in community. Okay, dia strong, adorable, strange. Okay, all in one, eh? Adorable kan? Okay. Adorable. Okay, so bila time diorang kena apa ni, a season apa diorang ada ni lah, bila time dia, dia akan pergi fish hunting. Okay, so diorang akan pergi at the tip of the iceberg and then akan look at the ocean. Okay, dia akan tengok sebab dia nak, ni lah, dia nak cari ikan kan, tapi dia kena tahu sama ada kat dalam tu ada ikan ataupun tak, ataupun ada predator. So usually, kan kalau kita tengok ni kan, usually akan ada no penguin akan start kalau satu penguin tak turun ke bawah, tak jump in first. So dia akan ada satu, this one penguin yang akan jump in first. And so happen that like typically is a female penguin lah, biasanya so female penguin yang biasanya cari food untuk ni, untuk anak-anak dia. Okay, bukan tak anak lah, untuk anak dan juga kumpulan dia sebenarnya. Okay, so so dan bila dia dah jump in, so dia akan tahulah sama ada ada ikan ke tak. Dan kalau ada ikan, then everyone can jump in and also makan ikan tu. Okay, so but what if dekat situ tak ada ikan? Okay, so dia just cari tempat lain lah. Okay, that's the worst thing that happen lah. Okay, but then what if kat situ ada predator? Okay, so kalau ada predator, okay, this penguin will find a way untuk lepaskan diri. So dia akan belajar. Okay, so apa yang best daripada being this first penguin? Sebab kan apa yang best being this first penguin kan? Dia try all the new things. Tapi orang lain pun, orang lain dapat belajar daripada dia kan, kesilapan dia, betul tak? Tapi dia yang first yang venture the new things. Okay, so bila looking at this penguin story kan, dalam buku tu cakap, so then dia tanya lah juga macam kenapa nak kena jadi first penguin, why can't you just be the rest of the penguin kan, tunggu the first one apa ni. Lepas tu, so what does this make it different kan? Yelah, sebenarnya when you become the first penguin, you not only like dapat untuk diri you, you get to venture this season kan, tapi actually you are making way for others, actually you are giving back. Tu yang dia cakap lah sebenarnya, being this first penguin is really you are giving back to the community sebenarnya. So this sebenarnya yang ni banyak lah eh. Kalau kita tengok eh, bila kita jadi first penguin ni sebenarnya kita create path untuk orang lain. And then yang best thing saya rasa bila kita dah go through any challenges, tapi kita yang first yang hadapi tu, kita boleh make our own design on how we want things to happen. Sebab kita first yang
venture.
Okay, and then so these people, okay, this first penguin people usually are breakthrough people, and also young people yang suka ni lah do disruptive, who have disruptive ideas. Okay, so yeah, let's be the first penguin. So that's why the award is given named as the first penguin.
Tapi kan Puan Nazli Nina, kalau nak mencelah lah, I think you bagi pandangan you lah, mungkin budaya kita di Malaysia ni, siapa yang jadi first penguin, contohnya dalam kelas lah. Okay, contohnya dalam kelas kita tengok anak-anak kita ataupun zaman kita sendiri dulu kan. Being a first penguin is not being appreciated enough. Betul tak?
Kadang-kadang dulu. Kadang orang kata the first row student. So sebenarnya the lesson from this penguin kan sebenarnya benda tu happen bila kita dalam group tau. Bila dalam group kita volunteer, tak ada orang nak volunteer.
Ada orang volunteer, betul.
So memang ini itulah apa represent the penguin lah sebab because it's in the group lah. Tapi itulah depends on the drive that you have kan.
Apa sebab tu kita kena appreciate student kita, anak-anak kita di kalangan kita pada mereka yang buat first move ni. Sebab budaya kita tak pernah nak appreciate orang yang buat first move ni. In fact, dia bagi orang kata a smirk. Ni mesti muka dia lagi. Ni mesti muka dia lagi. Kalau boleh kita kena tukar sikit supaya at least ambil lah orang kata natijah daripada First Penguin Award ni betul lah cara Randy Posh letak kan. Maknanya kita bagi award pada mereka yang buat effort. Betul tak Puan Zainal?
Betul. Betul. Who effort and also brave enough, you know, to try new things. And itulah kalau kita tengok sebenarnya successful people ialah people yang sebenarnya ni lah berani enough to pass the wall and become this penguin. Okay, so in the end kan sebenarnya lecture dia ialah achieving your childhood dream, okay. Tapi sebenarnya bila dia tulis-tulis in the end dia tunjuk sebenarnya when you live your life correctly, tapi cara yang betul, cara yang but you don't know betul until you have the failure kan. So if you live your way, okay, in a right way, it will lead to the dream. So the dream will come to you. Okay, and also in the end sebenarnya dia decided to make this into a book, his lecture into a book, because actually it's not only for the public to learn the lesson from him, but also actually he wanted to pass it to his children sebab anak dia kecil-kecil masa dia kena cancer tu, so dia fikir apa yang dia nak tinggalkan untuk anak-anak dia. So like we also have to think lah kan, apa yang kita nak tinggalkan untuk anak-anak kita. So itulah. So memang sebenarnya macam baca-baca tu memang kadang ada sesebar, ada tergenang di mata macam tu lah. Okay, this book. Though actually buku ni sebenarnya just straightforward je, tak ada bunga-bunga. Tapi I don't know lah bila saya baca macam tu lah. So this is just a timeline of about him. So ada lah in between details. So it's like he was born in 1960. Kemudian dia jadi professor in 1988. Okay. And then on 2006, he was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. And then, so dekat sini lah, in between this lah, he was asked to give a lecture and then on September, so he did. Dekat sini ada gambar dia pumping kan, so masa tu talk tu dia cakap, I think I'm more healthier than you guys because I can pump, I can pump much more than you. So sebenarnya dia tak suka lah orang macam belas kasihan kat dia, and he want to actually, he don't really want to talk about his cancer during his last lecture, okay. And then dekat sini dia kata that he have only 6 months of good health. So the rest memang dia balik kampung lah, kampung dengan mak dia sebenarnya, dengan wife dia, kampung belah wife dia sebab wife dia nanti boleh settle duduk dengan family wife dia. But then itulah Alhamdulillah kan, at the end pun before he pass away, dia dapat juga kasih speech for the class of 2008. Okay. And actually there is, okay, yeah, so this is a little bit all about him. Okay, nanti boleh, inilah anak dia, okay. I boleh read about this, so just I will explain on this. And this is his picture when he gave the last lecture. This was the picture when he gave the last lecture. So ini gambar dia dengan Jay and his kids. So masa time ni, itulah dalam buku tu dia ada cerita lah, dia suka plush toys, apa yang pergi fun fair dan dia dapat patung-patung kan.
Flash toys.
So dia ada banyak, tu. Lepas tu dia bagi hadiah lah dekat atas ni kan, dia ada banyak tadi yang besar. Okay, so dia bagi hadiah kat siapa-siapa, dekat dia lah siapa yang nak. So he bring that teddy bear lah dekat hall tu. And Yeah, this is a book and this is a video on his talk. Ada juga okay, dekat dalam kat TED Talks. Okay. But then, you know, Stephen King cakap books and movies are like apples and orange. They both are fruits but they taste completely different. So saya sebenarnya inilah berterima kasih di atas inisiatif Ponta Hilal dan team okay, untuk buat this kind of sharing session, because when you watch and you read it's different. But to the next level is that when the next level is that when you write. When you manage to write, it's another level of inilah apa different level of mentality. Okay, so I think that's all from me. Okay, saya harap itulah ia bermanfaat untuk semua. Yes,
wow.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih banyak.
Belum lagi akhir. Okey, kalau Puan Azlinda boleh tengok kat dalam chat room tu kan, ramai yang berkongsi, cerita balik, ambil poin penting, make the phone call short. Okey, Pomodoro teknik. Ini actually saya apply Pomodoro teknik masa saya menulis. Okey. Peta Freestone, Dr. Peta Freestone yang bagi cara ni untuk perkenalkan supaya bila kita nak buat, actually boleh apply untuk semua benda Pomodoro teknik ni. 15 minutes, 5 minutes, I think the last talk yang saya bagi pun saya cakap pasal benda ni juga. Let's talk, do more, happy feet. Yes, kalau you nak tahu pasal penguin, you tengok cerita happy feet. What you give back to the community. Penguin is good for teamwork. Budaya menghargai berbanding mengkritik. Yang saya rasa saya nampak ialah what you give back to the community lah. Right? So the first penguin must be bold, we must appreciate and thankful. Ya, yeah, betul. Okay, thank you. So cumanya kalau pada hadirin yang ada kat sini ni, yang dengar ni, sebelum sesi kita bermula, saya sebenarnya dah bersharing dengan Puan Zinda lah. Tengok persepsi bila kita buat resensi buku ni, sebab saya tak nampak pun PDF Puan Azlinda until today. Betul kan Puan Azlinda?
Right? Betul.
So and we have this kind of chat sebab Puan Lin dia kata dia risau, nervous lah apalah dengan soalan yang saya bagi. Okay, so bila saya baca buku ni, yang saya nampak ialah lain. Betul tak? Kan?
Betul-betul.
So, yang hari ni Puan Lin Azlinda share dengan saya is different perspective. Yang saya rasa wow, cantiknya buku ni, kita ni nampak benda yang lain. Jadi saya nampak buku ni, kalau yang hadirin nak tahu, saya nampak buku ni macam mana saya nak pastikan anak-anak saya dapat fun seperti mana saya dapat fun masa kecil. Okay, life should be very fun. Because kita tak tahu nanti macam tadi Puan Lin cakap akhir tadi, apa yang kita nak tinggalkan pada anak-anak kita. Kan? So saya nampak buku last lecture ni berat sangat masa saya baca. Macam you baca, you rasa wow, sehari je habis. Betul tak? Macam saya baca, saya rasa macam it's hard for me because I am very straightforward, strict person. Saya very affirmative. Saya jenis yang structured. Macam you cakap tadi kan, kena ni. Tapi bila berlibatkan fun tu, saya kena latih diri saya. So when today you share dengan us a very smooth way of kata, how do you look on this book? Wow, Masya Allah, Tabarakallah, thank you very much. Yeah, kita nampak tak persepsi buku ni akan berbeza bila orang lain yang baca. Ini yang kita nak, kalau boleh lebih banyak lagi input yang diberikan lah.
Dan saya nak kongsi juga kan sebenarnya, bukan setakat orang yang baca, even kita baca di different time phase. Maksudnya kita baca masa umur 20, lain kita punya perspektif. Bila kita baca balik, sekarang pun saya boleh macam, dulu tak fikir macam ni, sekarang fikir macam ni. Because based on we can relate of our different experience kan, that we face as we go older.
Yes, betul-betul tu. Saya setuju sangat.
Saya nak terima kasih banyaklah kepada semua ni pendengar ni kan. Encik Muhammad Nasir, Dr. Syam. Okay, semua ni lah. Okay, itulah. Terharu juga guys. Terima kasih banyak.
Alhamdulillah. So ada soalan ke daripada semua pendengar? Saya rasa Alhamdulillah kita ada daripada admin, kita ada dari staff. InsyaAllah jangan risau, kita ada rakaman sebenarnya. So tapi yang pentingnya bila dengar secara live ni lagi menarik. Sebab kita nampak, kita dah boleh tulis pun kita nampak apa poin yang kita nak tulis. Sampai hari ni kita dah 4 buku lah kita baca. Lebih kurang lah maksudnya. So siapa yang tertarik, macam 2 weeks ago saya perasan macam bila Dr. Mahfuzah share buku Asuhan Budi, ada ramai yang nak pergi cari buku Asuhan Budi. In fact, kalau buat pengetahuan hadirin, ada macam masa Dr. Mahfuzah sharing sessionnya, dia baca buku Zakbar tanpa kenal Zakbar tu sendiri. Okay, betul tak Dr. Mahfuzah? Correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, so those were the days, orang kata betul lah bila Puan Azli Rinda cakap timeline tu akan menentukan buku tu pergi ke mana. InsyaAllah. So Aizuddin, soalan tak ada kat Tahira, nak roti telur je. Astaghfirullahalazim. InsyaAllah akan sampai bila ku sampai di sana. Ramai yang rindu roti telur ya. Ya, nanti kita akan beli ya. InsyaAllah. Okay. So itu sahaja daripada pihak saya. Rasanya Puan Zainal nak tambah sepatah dua kata. That's it. Itu sahaja. Okay, last. Last. Last je. Knowing you before and now, okay, sebab nak cakap nanti bias kan, you are very energetic, memang you contribute more. So buat program dengan Azli Linda pun saya nampak bila dia down to earth buat program tu memang all out. What do you kata keep in your mind bila you buat benda-benda tu semua?
Allahu Akbar. Okay, Dr. Tahira ni as a jurid too much, I think. Saya tak tahu lah Tahira, I think, tapi itulah macam saya cakap, yeah, before saya jadi lecturer kan, I was with the industry and then memang saya nak jadi pendidik lah, sebenarnya saya nak jadi pendidik. So I think because of that kot, and then because I have that feeling kot, so I just buat je lah whatever I think right kot. Does that answer your question?
No, you're still holding it.
Okay, can you rephrase back your question?
What makes you kata keep moving on? You daripada industri, you daripada kata satu dunia yang mungkin sebab ramai yang tak tahu Puan Zainal ni daripada industri yang dah merantau ke kata ke pelosok dunia dah untuk jadi engineer yang orang kata termasyur lah. Tapi bila dia masuk pendidik ni, satu dunia yang berbeza. Tapi bila dia boleh buat kerja yang saya rasa saya pun tak mampu buat macam mana passion dia buat. So what keeps you kata in your passion tu? Okay.
Serius lah, saya tak tahu kau nak jawab ni. Cuma kan, okay, masa saya kerja dulu kan, saya tak tahu, saya macam limited lah masa saya jadi engineer tu. Macam limited tu macam, okay, kena kerja and facing instrument and people macam tu. And then meetings. Tapi bila saya masuk lecturer ni, sebenarnya kan saya sangat teruja sebab apa, you can do a lot of things tau bila jadi lecturer ni. Semua benda you boleh buat apa. You boleh buat social, apa maksudnya apa community network, you boleh give to the community. Masuk industri boleh tapi macam susah tau. It's like you dah committed dengan kerja tapi you have to masuk team ni tapi you dah tak ada technical lagi like, okay, so itulah. So sebenarnya saya itulah saya bersyukur sangat kan, and I would like itulah every lectures to also feel bersyukur bahawa okay, projek orang asli, insyaAllah. Bahawa kan, bersyukur lah bila dapat masuk akademisyen ni, dalam universiti ni kan, not only lecturer lah, saya rasa yang lain pun, you have the chance untuk buat any, to give back from any sudut. So, itulah yang saya, sebab tu kot, sebab saya masih rasa teruja sebab benda tu kot.
Betul. Sebab saya rasa bila kita terlibat dalam akademik sesatunya moderator sungguh nak jawapan dari speaker ni. Susah kalau orang tak nak jawab, nak kena jawab juga. Memang saya akan minta sebab dia very orang kata dia tak nak bagi yang tu, saya akan korek juga sampai dapat. Tapi sebenarnya jawapan tu yang saya nak. Sebab setahu saya yang mana ada dekat sini ni dah pernah bekerja dengan saya setakat, bukan setakat akademik saja. Even though staff pun, even though driver pun ada Cik Nasir dalam ni, saya akan bawa dia ke program saya, program orang asli pun bersama-sama dengan saya untuk menjayakan dan nampak hasil suci murni apa yang kita buat tu. So we are as a team. Itu yang kita nampak lah insyaAllah. So Alhamdulillah, thank you very much for answering the questions. Siap speaker pula bagi masa kat saya, ada 2 minit lagi. Okay, untuk pada mereka yang dah dapat link orang kata kehadiran boleh isi. Okay, untuk ahli-ahli pewani boleh masuk Webex. Thank you very much for staying on. Alhamdulillah, kita tangguhkan majlis kita dengan tasbih kifarah dan surah wal'as. Amin, 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 ya Rabbal Alamin. Thank you very much semua. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.